Salt Lake City, Utah, no stranger to staging global events, has broken new ground.
The United Nations and I look to you for ideas and solutions.
Playing host to the three-day United Nations Civil Society Conference at the Salt Palace.
This is my first time in Utah, and looking at the landscape and the wonderful people I've met, I think this is something unique, and having this conference here in Utah says a lot about what they are basically doing as far as mitigating issues that have to do with climate change is concerned. So I see that as something that is very special, the people and the beautiful landscape that is here.
Actually, this is the first time to come to the Utah, so this is quite different from the mountain areas, but I can see a lot of nature, and then there's people in the peace, and quite impressive for me.
It's the first time the UN's Civil Society has held its annual conference outside of New York in its 68-year history. With Salt Lake City, Utah, being selected as a place that embodies the ideals of a civil society, where inclusion, resilience, and sustainable growth are fostered and realized, especially as cities and urban centers continue to grow around the world.
So we must plan wisely as we move toward rolling out the future of living in cities and moving away from townships and moving away from villages, and especially from the rural communities. And I'm hoping that the knowledge and what they vision and see within those cities will be attracted then from the rural, that they will go back and talk about agribusiness and sustain those communities they come from.
So I was rather looking forward to connect with people who can talk about faith and who can spread the message of oneness. At least Salt Lake City is making people to come together, and what I've heard is 4,000 to 5,000 people have signed up for this conference, which is amazing.
The three-day conference will bring some 5,000 people to Salt Lake from more than 130 countries as they discuss an array of topics that include climate and environmental concerns, renewable energy developments, caring for refugees, and provide an opportunity for the Latter-day Saint community and Friends of the Church to volunteer with JustServe as youth and adults begin packaging some 375,000 meals for people in need.
The fact that we can bring people together to work shoulder to shoulder on something that we care about, it's a good example of that.
Coverage of the United Nations Civil Society and the JustServe initiative will continue during the second day of the conference.